In this video, I'm going to explain what the 95% confidence interval is and how you can calculate and interpret it. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The confidence interval, abbreviated as CI, expresses the degree of uncertainty around a certain effect. These values can often give you an idea about the size and thus the power of a study. The size of the confidence interval is then directly related to the size of the study. The more participants, the smaller the confidence interval, and the more precise the estimated effect. This becomes clear when we look at the calculation of the confidence interval in a sample with a normal distribution. Okay, let's say we have a sample of 1000 patients and we have found a change in range of motion in the shoulder of 14 degrees with a standard deviation of 5 degrees after our intervention. Then we can calculate the confidence interval by taking the set value times the standard deviation divided through the root of the number of patients. The set value can be derived from the table next to me and shows us which area is contained in the confidence interval of our result. So in case of the 95% confidence interval, we take all values between minus 1.96 times and plus 1.96 times the standard deviation. For more information on normal distribution and standard deviation, click on the info button in the top right corner. So in our example, we take 1.96 times 5 divided through the root of 1000, and we then get 0.31. This means that if we were to conduct the study 100 times, we will get a result that will fall within 14 plus 0.31, so 14.31, and 14 minus 0.31, so 13.69, in 95 out of 100 cases. So in 5 out of 100 cases, we will find a result that will fall out of the confidence interval. Let's say we found this effect in 25 patients. Then we end up with a 95% confidence interval of 1.96 times 5 through the root of 25. So in total, 1.96 times 1. Then we would find a result between 12.04 and 15.96 in 95 out of 100 cases. So the confidence interval got wider and our results less precise. Less frequently, confidence intervals with 90% and 80% confidence are chosen. A lower confidence interval will lead to a lower set value and a smaller interval and vice versa. If we are comparing the difference between interventions and we want to test for statistical significance, the confidence interval can help us. If we find a result with a confidence interval that crosses zero, we can conclude the 95% confidence interval contains zero, so the results are not statistically significant. In other words, the intervention is not effective, or intervention A is not more effective than intervention B. The opposite can also be true. If we have a confidence interval that does not contain zero, so in our range of motion example, we have a change of 14 degrees with a 95 confidence interval between 13.69 to 14.31 degrees, we can conclude that the results are statistically significant. The most important question, however, is again if the results are clinically relevant. For this reason, there are better alternatives than the p-value. We will get into this in another video. Alright, this concludes our video on confidence intervals. I would like to thank you very much for watching. Please leave a like or comment down below. And for more info about us, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, or physiotutors.com. And I'll see you next time. Bye.